Hi guys, and welcome to Neat Video Tutorials. This is going to be a very quick video about our Performance Optimizer tool, and you will love what you're going to learn today. Let's dive right into it. This is the window of Neat Video's Optimizer tool, which controls how Neat Video is using your resources. Now, I'll show you where you can find it. Go to Tools, Preferences, Performance. Here you can see three different modes. CPU only, which is the default, GPU only, and CPU and GPU. Now, let's check the speed you can get with these settings. Click this button. All right, in the CPU only mode, working on 4K clip, my computer can get 8.1 frames per second. Now, the most interesting part. Click Optimize Settings, Start. And Neat Video has started checking what the best combination of hardware is for this specific clip and filter settings. In my case, it's GPU. This will give me 12.2 frames per second. That's much better than 8.1 that I had with CPU only. Now, I need to accept best combination. Cool. This slider is showing how much of GPU memory Neat Video is allowed to use. We generally recommend to only change these settings if you're getting GPU errors during rendering or looking to extract every drop of performance from your hardware. The green triangle is showing the optimum amount of memory required for best performance on videos with the current frame size. The red bar on the right shows how much memory is used by the operating system, video editing software, and other programs, so don't go here. If you are experiencing GPU-related problems during render, you may want to move the memory slider to the left of the green triangle, especially if it's currently in the red area. Neat Video's speed may decrease when you do it, but the drop in speed may not necessarily be noticeable with some filter settings. You can check the impact directly by clicking Check Speed. If you go higher than the green triangle, Neat Video will actually not use more GPU memory with the current frame size and its speed will not increase. However, if you switch to a video with larger frames, then the green triangle will move to the right and the higher limit will help Neat Video work faster. In any case, keep the slider out of the red zone. Otherwise, your video editing application or the whole system may slow down or become less stable. And that's all done. Guys, remember doing this every time you switch between video formats, change temporal radius or Neat Video quality settings, upgrade hardware. All those factors affect the speed of individual devices differently, thus the balance may change. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel and give this video a thumbs up. We'll be back with new videos soon. And that's it.